يشرفني باسم دولة الإمارات قيادة وحكومة وشعبا أن أعرب عن تقديرنا العميق للثقة الكبيرة باختيار بلادي الإمارات العربية المتحدة لاستضافة الدورة 28 من مؤتمر الأطراف في اتفاقية الأمم المتحدة الإطارية بشأن تغير المناخ.
As much as I was happy to read that the United Arab Emirates will host the Global Summit COP28 in the year 2023, I kept thinking about the lessons such an announcement entails. For one, the world needs the United Arab Emirates. The Emirates has become an important player in international politics, and the role of the Emirates is now indispensable for the course of international relations. Global environmental issues have assumed so much importance in the course of relations among nations, to the extent that any global conference on the environment takes the lead aggregating the effort of all nations to be more responsible and take actions that will save the environment and protect planet Earth.
It's very exciting news to hear that COP28 will be held in the United Arab Emirates. And some of the things that I personally would look to see come out of this gathering have to do a lot with the business commitments that have been made by various business leaders and important leaders in industry, because although it is important to make commitments in terms of reducing emissions on a country-by-country level, a lot of the global emissions actually come from industries that make up that emit more carbon emissions than single countries. And so it's very important to see these business leaders and these leaders in industry making commitments to reduce their carbon emissions across the value chain. And we definitely saw some important steps moving forward with this at COP26 in Glasgow, including, for example, the First Movers Coalition. But these commitments will need to be both reaffirmed and expanded on in subsequent years. And so I'm looking to see more of that and to see more industries get on board with the goals that are being expressed by various countries and leaders. And in some respects, these businesses can really make a difference beyond the regulatory framework that's going on a governmental level, and can actually be leaders and show a lot of leadership in terms of carbon reduction that is happening in the extra-governmental sphere.
The Emirates had the scientific base to host such a conference and gather all the nations in a sophisticated and purposeful discussions on how to use an international climate conference to establish consensus on how to purify the environment. Of course, such a scientific infrastructure is growing and being enhanced year after year. Another lesson to be learned is that the Emirates is trusted to organize such a critical conference. For sure, the Emirates respects its commitments agreed upon at any international climate conference to abide by its recommendations. The United Arab Emirates has instituted the value of cooperation to sustain a decent regional and global behavior expressed by an aspiring nation to contribute more positively to the welfare of all nations.
I think the importance of UAE's ability to host COP28 is a sign of UAE's growing international importance and its activity and its focus on being at the center of solving some of the biggest international challenges on humanitarian issues, on energy issues, on climate issues. As an example of that, UAE just recently concluded a multi-billion dollar deal with the United States to combat climate change. It puts it in a forward-looking position towards its own hosting duties in 2 years from now. And it also puts it on the center stage to challenge some of the biggest obstacles en route to tackling environmental issues. It is true that there are many challenges to face, namely some countries that are actually at the forefront of polluting activity have not been present this time around. But UAE's example can still make a difference in innovative breakthrough solutions that matter on a day-to-day basis far beyond lofty rhetoric of international gatherings.
This conference is the continuation of a previous and a pioneering initiative submitted by the UAE during Expo 2020. I am quoting the statement by Sheikh Mohammed bin Zayed Al Nahyan when he said, "With our announcement today of our plan to achieve climate neutrality by 2050, the UAE continues our effective role in climate control issues, adding our support to international efforts to mitigate climate change with a range of effective community and economic initiatives. In achieving climate neutrality in the UAE by 2050, we aim to develop an approach that both drives sustainable economic growth and is an exemplar of working together to achieve a better future for humanity. No doubt, the United Nations and the whole world community built its whole effort on having the Emirates as the host of COP28 due to the sound domestic environmental planning by the UAE to promulgate climate neutrality as a policy obligation."
I think the UAE has been a pioneer in a lot of clean energy technologies, and I'm really pleased by their adoption of nuclear energy with their 1-2-3 agreement with the IAEA, which is giving them clean, renewable power. And for a country that is reliant largely on petrochemicals for their economy, it's showing a lot of initiative and leadership to say, we're going to use this technology, which has been proven to be safe, clean, and renewable. And I think that is ultimately what the rest of the Middle East should start looking at, is how do we strike agreements with the IAEA to have nuclear energy. It's been unfortunate that countries like France and Germany are reducing their share of nuclear energy. If you want to combat climate change, if you want to get rid of carbon emissions, nuclear power is by far and away the cleanest, cheapest, and most efficient way to do it, and especially in a way that doesn't help economies like Iran and Russia that produce a lot of the oil, or countries like China, which produce a lot of the solar panels. All those countries use clean energy to, or the prospect of energy sources, to advance their own geopolitical efforts. And I think it's good that the United Arab Emirates is taking an alternative approach that is maybe difficult politically, but is going to yield good results in the long term. And I think that's a good symptom of why they've been given the COP28 conference hosting privilege. I think it's important that you include the GCC countries in the climate talks. Ultimately, their economies are going to be massively impacted by the switch from fossil fuels into renewable energy sources. And so it's good to include them in the conversation and say, you know, you guys can actually, more so than being chief oil producers, they are chief energy producers for the rest of the world. And I think that gives them a really great opportunity to show bold leadership throughout the world and say, here's an example of how you can transition your economy from fossil fuels to other types of energy supplies.
Moreover, I read happily the statements issued by the UAE's Minister of Industry and Advanced Technology and Special Envoy, Dr. Sultan Ahmed Al-Jaber, when he made it clear that his country will spare no effort to narrow the differences between the rich and the poor nations over how to spur positive climate actions to save the environment. I personally appreciate very much his attitude expressed as an inclusive approach to combine as different sectors as possible in many societies and economies to advance common climate acts. One good example of such a wise diplomatic attitude is the willingness by the United Arab Emirates to assist Egypt to host the 27th session of the Conference of the Parties. This should help execute important executive decisions on the environment. Yet again, the world has all the confidence in the United Arab Emirates to evaluate fairly the environment criteria necessitated for each nation.
To talk about environment, it's good to see these type of events goes to the Middle East, because everything we are hearing from Middle East for last couple of decades is just war, it's just terrorism, and coup d'etat, these type of things. And hopefully the people who are working on this field are more serious and not just talk and show, and then the next generation in Middle East will have a lot more valuable things to talk about instead of terrorism and a lot of other problems in that area. And I'm sure UAE can be a good candidate for these type of meetings, because they showed during last two decades at least, that they are, it's a lot of progress over there, and the economy is very good, and hopefully they can show a better face of Middle East to people in our small planet.
In all aspects, the Emirates is providing a great model for the whole region of the Middle East, the Arab world, and the Islamic world on how to be the mastermind of the tendency to protect the environment. Finally, this great work has its origin in the great vision that Sheikh Zayed bin Sultan Al Nahyan entertained for the Emirates. As Minister of Foreign Affairs and International Cooperation, Sheikh Abdullah bin Zayed Al Nahyan concluded, "The founding father of the UAE had the highest regard for the environment, and it is his legacy which has inspired the progress we have made over the past 50 years to diversify our economy, and will continue to inspire us as we strive to safeguard the well-being of present and future generations."
Hey, Maria Malouf here. Please click to like and subscribe to Maria Malouf TV YouTube page and catch our hottest interviews and most compelling analysis. You will not get it anywhere else.